Hydrogen cars have been around for decades, but they've never really caught on. They're expensive, there are few hydrogen fueling stations, and the technology just isn't quite there yet. All of that, however, might be about to change. In recent years, there's been a renewed interest in hydrogen cars, driven by concerns about climate change and the need for cleaner transportation options. These cars are great in this regard because they produce no emissions. They're also quite efficient and can be refueled in just a few minutes. Hello everyone and welcome back to MIR Media. In this video, we'll explore one of the most hotly debated topics in the field of alternative energy, the potential of hydrogen-powered cars. Are these finally ready for prime time? To answer this, we're actually going to go back all the way to the 1800s to discover how hydrogen cars originated. We'll then take a look at how interest in them has waxed and waned over time before discussing where they stand now and what the future holds for them. Before we proceed though, if you haven't already subscribed to our channel, could I pretty please request that you please do so? We're a team that's working really hard to bring you these videos, and we need to reach 1,000 subscribers so YouTube will allow us to monetize our channel. Your support means everything to us, even if it's free. Now let's dive in. The concept of hydrogen-powered cars isn't new. In fact, the first time that someone ever thought of creating one was way back in the 1800s, and in 1860, a Belgian inventor by the name of Etienne Lenoir, I hope I said the name right, became the first ever person to create a three-wheeled hydrogen-powered vehicle called the Hippomobile. This wasn't really a car though, it was a cross between a horse carriage and a tricycle that was powered using a one-cylinder, two-stroke engine that ran on hydrogen fuel. The idea of a true hydrogen car remained largely theoretical until the 1960s, when General Motors built the first true prototype powered by a hydrogen fuel cell. This development is what truly marked the inception of a new era in the automobile industry. The 1970s were a difficult decade. Egypt, Syria, and Israel went to war, while Iran experienced a revolution. These events created an oil shortage that drove up the price of oil. The shortage also meant that fuel now had to be rationed and that many people had to wait in long lines to fill up their tanks. The demand for cars dropped as people were less likely to buy them when gasoline was expensive, and those who did have them reduced their usage. The oil crisis exposed the vulnerabilities of an oil-dependent transportation sector and showed that countries that were heavily reliant on oil for transportation were vulnerable to price shocks. As a result, many countries began investing in alternative energy sources to become more energy secure, and hydrogen cars saw renewed interest. Despite the surge of interest, however, the hydrogen internal combustion engine technology was still in its early phases of development, and technological limitations meant that hydrogen cars remained a niche product. By the 1990s, the discussion around climate change had begun to intensify, and hydrogen cars, which produced only water vapor as a byproduct, were seen as a potential solution to the problem of greenhouse gas emissions. Hydrogen cars had also come a long way since the 1970s, and many new hydrogen cars became available during this decade, including the GM EV1 fuel cell automobile, the BMW 728HL and 750HL, Ford P2000 FC, which was also the world's first full-size 5-seat passenger fuel cell car, and many other Honda FCX models. By the 2000s, the efficiency of using hydrogen in internal combustion engines was still only 20-25%, and the power output was low compared to fossil fuel engines. Nevertheless, available investment and government funding for the cars began to increase worldwide. BMW, for instance, developed a hydrogen prototype car based on its X5 SUV with funding support from the German government, while President Bush launched the Freedom Car and Fuel Initiative, which was a research and development program funded by the federal government and by private industry that aimed to develop technologies that would make hydrogen fuel cell vehicles more affordable and efficient. These efforts paid off, and in 2014, Toyota launched the first mass-produced hydrogen car and called it the Mirai, the Japanese word for future. The Mirai is available in the United States, Japan, Europe, and China, and has an impressive range of around 312 miles or 502 kilometers on a full tank of hydrogen. As things currently stand, the hydrogen car industry is continuing to develop. Hydrogen cars hold tremendous promise in terms of environmental sustainability. They can be refueled quickly and are seen as one of the only two key sustainable fuel technologies alongside electric cars. While distribution infrastructure for hydrogen is still underdeveloped, the industry is nevertheless progressing quickly. In 2022, the EcoRunner 11 drove non-stop for 36 hours and covered an astounding distance of 1196 kilometers to set the world record for the longest distance traveled in a hydrogen vehicle. Hyundai, on the other hand, just premiered its Exeunt fuel cell tractor for the North American commercial vehicle market. The vehicle leverages Hyundai's Exeunt fuel cell, which since its launch in 2020, has successfully accumulated over 4 million miles and, according to the company, is the only heavy-duty fuel cell electric model with a proven record of real-world application and technological reliability. Advancements have also been made in the space of hydrogen production. German company Graphos and Australian company Worley, for instance, have partnered to scale plasmolysis technology for methane to hydrogen production in the Asia Pacific, illustrating a shift towards more sustainable and efficient hydrogen production methods. The future of hydrogen cars, while promising, isn't without its share of challenges and debates. Hydrogen storage is a key hurdle that also significantly influences how these cars are designed. High-pressure tanks and cutting-edge materials are needed for hydrogen storage, and this has implications for the weight, cost, and safety of hydrogen vehicles. The cost-effective and environmentally friendly production and distribution of hydrogen is also a challenge. Hydrogen may be the most abundant element in the universe, but it doesn't exist freely in nature and must be extracted by reforming natural gas or electrolyzing water, and both methods have their own set of economic and environmental implications. Uncertainty also hovers around the ideal design and return on investment for green hydrogen plants, while the inadequacy of the current infrastructure for hydrogen refueling makes the cars impractical for daily use for most people. Three main problems, thus, need to be solved to facilitate the wider adoption of hydrogen fuel cell cars. The first is cost. Hydrogen fuel cells are expensive, and this is a barrier to the mass adoption of hydrogen cars. As the technology matures, though, costs are expected to come down. The second is availability. Very few hydrogen fueling stations currently exist, but this number is projected to rise in future. The third is the design of green hydrogen plants to maximize ROI while minimizing the environmental impact of hydrogen production. Despite these challenges, however, there is still a lot of potential for hydrogen cars to become a major part of the transportation landscape in the coming years. As the technology matures, the cost of hydrogen fuel cells decreases, and the number of fueling stations increases, the cars will likely become more affordable and more widely available. So what's the verdict here? Are hydrogen cars ready for prime time? So far, the cars haven't been able to go mainstream, despite the fact that the first mass-produced hydrogen car came to market in 2014. That said, however, the global hydrogen market is still growing and receiving a lot of investment from governments and private companies around the world, and several of the biggest automakers have announced new fuel cell developments and made it clear that hydrogen cars will be a part of their offerings going forward. Toyota and Hyundai, for instance, are expanding their hydrogen car lineups. Toyota has announced that it will release a new hydrogen car in 2023, and Hyundai has announced that it will release a new hydrogen SUV in 2024. Honda, on the other hand, is developing a hydrogen fuel cell motorcycle, which is expected to be released in 2025. There are also currently over 400 fueling stations in the United States, but this number is expected to increase in the coming years. Overall, the outlook for hydrogen fuel cells and hydrogen-powered engines in cars is positive. The final verdict, however, truly depends on how successfully the challenges to the mass adoption of hydrogen cars are addressed, and how effectively hydrogen cars can compete with other clean energy alternatives, including electric vehicles, in the coming years. Thank you for watching this video all the way to the end. I'll see you again in the next one.